Hey guys, welcome. Welcome back to ETLQL Apps. So in this session, we will try to understand what are the constraints on SQL. So first of all, we'll try to understand what is constraints, right? So constraint in layman language, you can assume that it is a kind of rule that as part of our table creation, we can enforce on the different columns in the table, right? So that we can enforce all those rules so that user should follow that rule, right? So it's kind of restriction on data insertion on those columns, right? So it's basically, you can assume that it's a rule that the user has to follow after those rules are enforced, right? So we will see how all these constraints are working. So we have got basically not null, unique, check, default, primary key, foreign key, right? So these are the major constraints that are there in SQL, right? Or in the database, you can say, right? So almost all the databases are following the same kind of constraints, right? And so what we will try to do is, in this session, probably I think primary key and foreign key constraint we will cover as part of later, because these are little bigger topics, but we will try to cover at least these four, right, in this session. So we will try to understand what are these, right? So first of all we will try to see what is not null constraint, right? So not null, as name suggests, that it will not allow the null value. So for example, you have employee, all right guys, for example, you have, one second, okay, I'll try to put something here that will be helpful, okay, to type something, okay, all right, let me just remove it, okay guys. Alright, so not null is basically, what is null, right? So null is, it's empty, right? It's not zero, it's empty, which means there is no value defined on that particular column. So for example, if I have employee number and I define it as a not null, correct? Not null, if I say, which means we need to mandatorily, we have to enter the value in that particular employee number, otherwise it will throw you an error so if you want to mandate any columns to be put in, right, you have to say not null against that particular column, right? So we will see the practical implementation, but for now you understand this, the column that we have to fill the value, without that it is not possible and it will throw you an error. So that particular column we have to define as a not null. Then second constraint is called unique constraint. So unique constraint is basically, as name suggests, that it will allow only unique values, which means it will only allow the non-duplicate values, right? So duplicate will not be allowed. For example, in the same thing, let's say employee number is there, I should not be able to insert 1 and 1 two times, yeah, I mean more than one times it will not be allowed, okay? However, null, since null is empty value, right, and one null cannot be compared with other null, which means there will be multiple null values allowed in unique unique constraint. If something is, some column is defined as unique, then multiple null values will be allowed, because each null value is undefined, so none of them are actually you cannot say that one null value equal to other null value. So that's why multiple null values are allowed, but in terms of any absolute value, there is only single value allowed in unique constraint, right? That's why it is called unique. We have third one is the check constraint. So check constraint basically help you to validate certain values within that range, right? So for example, if I say that salary should be greater than 1000 rupees, right, which means you cannot actually give salary less than 1000, So in that case, you know, we can put the check constraint. So if you are inserting the salary less than 1000 rupees, then it will be throwing an error, right? So this is called check constraint. All right, and then we have default constraint. So default is basically, you know what, if you are basically not inserting any value, right, and then what will happen, and that is also not defined, and that column is not defined as not null, obviously, then in that case what will happen is you can actually provide a default value that will be populated in case you are not inserting any value, right? So that also we will see. So let's start see the practical implementation, right? So we will try to implement all these four over there. Okay, all right, so let me, okay, so I have let me see if I have table already created. I need to drop it. Okay, let me drop it. Okay, I want to drop it, table emp. Now dropped. So let me create a table with all these constraints. So create table emp, and then I will say employee number. So what I want to do as part of employee number is I want to give two constraint. Okay, first of all I need to define the number, the value, obviously, right? So let's say I'm going to say 3, or let's say 5 I'm giving, right, value. And then I'm going to say the employee number is fine. Okay, employee number should not be null, first of all. Okay, so I will say not null to this one. And also if it is a not null, then also one constraint that I can put is, okay, for now let it be not null. All right, also I think I can just check that, make sure that, you know, employee number is check, employee number is greater than 0, right? Obviously, right, it should not be 0 or less than 0, correct? So that is the reason I'm just putting it. Now employee number is done, let's say employee name, and I'll say varchar, I will say 30 size. And then against the name, yeah, I don't want to put it here. Maybe that's fine. I will say salary. Okay, salary. I will say if there is no salary for that particular employee, then all right. I think I should put some check constraint here. So check salary. Check salary should be greater than 1000. Okay, I want to give salary more than 1000. And then employee name, employee number, employee name, salary, what else? Okay, department number. So I will try to do DPT number. All right guys, here I forgot to put the data type and the column size. Salary, I will say here maybe 5 digit. Okay, all right, now the last one I would say it's number, and 5 maybe. Okay, and then I will say default number will be 99. If, all right, so guys, you see that I have created a table and I have enforced all this constraints, right? Not null, I think I forgot unique. All right, I will okay, let me drop it. Okay, I will try to table emp, so for better, right, I will just try to say unique constraint also, right? Here employee number, it should be unique, right? Not null is fine, but also unique constraint, unique constraint. Okay guys, table created. Now let's see how it is created, right? So what actually I have created is I have used unique constraint, not null constraint on this employee number, right? And also the check constraint. So it will be basically unique greater than 0. So it can start from 1. It will be unique, which means it will not take the duplicate, and also not null. Okay, these are the three constraints that I am putting on this. And then employee name, there is no constraint on this. It can be left blank also. And then salary, so salary should be greater than 1000. And department number, if I am not giving any department number, leaving blank, then it will be populated as 99, right? So let's try to insert the value and see how the rules are, you know, enforcing it. So let's try insert into emp. All right, I am just trying to put employee number, employee name, then salary. All right, salary, and then what's that DPT ID? DPT number, right? DPT number. All right, guys, and then values. I will try to say 10, and here name Akash, maybe I'll put something. Okay, and then salary is 1200, and then department number is, let's say, 100. All right, try. It's created, right? Now, since this is following all the value, right? Now, what I have done is I have, in as per this constraint, right? It should be unique. So if I try to insert this again, the 10 is no more unique because we already inserted one. So it should throw a unique key constraint error now. Okay, let me try to insert the same record. You see, guys, it is actually giving you error, unique key constraint violation, right? Because 10, the employee number should be unique, but we are trying to insert again 10, right? So what I will do is I will try to insert. Okay, I want to check other constraint. Okay, what is that other constraint? The check constraint. Okay, so check constraint, basically what it will do, it will it should only allow more than, I mean greater than, so I will put minus 10, right? Because it should allow only greater than 0 value, right? So this should also give a check constraint error. See, guys, this is giving check constraint violation, right? Because the employee number is less than 10, less than 0. As per rule, it is you know, not following this rule. So this is the testing of that thing, right? And then third thing, guys, I want to also check. Let's say I just want to leave employee number as a blank. Okay, so I have defined one more rule. What is that? I have defined one more rule, the not null constraint here. So as per not null, I am actually trying to insert the null, which means I am not trying to insert anything, empty value, which means null. It should also give you not null constraint violation, that kind of error. So it says that cannot insert null into system EMP E number, right? So you see, all the three different constraints we tried to test, and then, you know, this is how it is enforcing, right? Second constraint that I would like to check is what I have done here is the department number, right? So if you look at this department number, I have inserted as 100 in the previous record, right? 100. Now I just want to leave it blank. All right, so department number, I just want to, don't want to insert it, I want to leave it blank. So it should actually, what should happen is I have given the default, right? So it should actually insert the 99 in this case, and this I must correct it. Let's say I'm putting 12, okay, and Akas, I will say something, Vikas maybe. All right, inserted. Now let's check whether 99 is inserted against department number. See here, guys, this is inserted 99, right, against this. So this is the another, you know, constraint that we have to check. So what we have looked at, we have looked at not null, unique also, right? On this, right? So employee number was having a couple of constraints over here. Let me just go up and I'll show you. What are the constraints here? So you see, we have checked unique, check constraint, not null constraint, and also the default constraint. So I think we have covered all of them, right? Yeah, guys, everything we have covered here. So hope this is making sense and you are able to understand it, right? So okay, I will try to show you one more thing here, right? So in this case, I think employee name field does not have any constraint, okay? So let me just try to remove it. I just don't want to give the employee name, and then it should be able to take the null value directly, okay? Okay, and department number, anyways, I am not putting it. So what will happen is it should take 99 anyways if I'm not giving, right? Let's try this. Okay, sorry, I think 12 is already given, so it's unique key violation. Now see, guys, okay, this is done. Now let's check what is coming with this, because so 99, this is okay, this is the one that we have selected, and we have inserted this 15, right? And you see that employee name is coming as null value because we have not defined any constraint here, so that's why it is taking as a null. Okay, so hope this video is making sense and you are able to understand the constraint. In the next video, I will cover the primary key and foreign key, and you know, then we will be done with the constraint. Okay, guys, thank you for watching this video. I think I try to explain everything, and try to, you know, practice it. And guys, please subscribe my channel so that I'll get motivation to create more and more videos for you, right? So I'm in this session, I'm trying to cover, you know, most of the from basic. Basically, I'm trying to cover the SQL. So once you watch all my videos from starting, I think there is no doubt that you should be able to crack all kind of SQL related interviews, right? So please watch one by one, serial wise, so that you will be able to understand everything, right? So I have tried to give you in-depth concept of everything here, and once I cover this basic, I will also try to cover little bit advanced topic also. So yeah, guys, this is all I wanted to talk about, you know, these four constraints, and happy learning until then, and I will see you with another video next time. Bye.